Notice that this algorithm does n over 2 additions at this statement. Then at this statement, it does n over 2 minus 1 additions. And finally, the add scan operates on a problem that's half the size. So what does that mean? Basically, the recurrence for the total work is this. So the work is linear in n. Before moving on to the span, let me make a quick remark. I hid a constant in here. What's the constant? As it happens, the constant is about 2. Now that 2 is counting only addition operations. Now this factor of 2 is pretty interesting. Think about what that means for a sec. The purely sequential algorithm only has a constant of about 1. So evidently, our parallel algorithm does twice the work. Now, wearing your theory hat, that's not a big deal. But it does raise an interesting and more general question. Will you, in general, need to pay some sort of price in order to get parallelism? Okay, Vuduk, enough with the distractions. What about the span? Now, the first observation is the recursive call, which always operates on a subproblem of half the size. So, you'd naturally expect about O of log n levels. All the other operations are data parallel. That means you can implement them using parallel 4s, which will also have logarithmic span. Putting that together, here's what the recurrence might look like. If you solve the recurrence, you will get O of log squared n. Again, the master theorem makes solving it quick and easy. Alternatively, you should be able to see the log squared n behavior intuitively. There's log n span from the statements within this function, and that's repeated log n times.